I think my coach has been very clear. This is a very serious matter, not only for ourselves, but for the people we represent in this house. And having a joint sitting, one of the reasons why we decided as chairs to have a joint sitting, it's because both cabinet secretaries were raising issues that they have been invited by both houses and they didn't know whether to appear before us or the Senate. And we made their life very easy to just appear on a joint sitting so that we can answer and they don't have to go to the Senate or come to us back and forth. And now having made your work easier, kindly also make our work easier. Because we don't want, again, somebody to say, I'm not responsible, I'm going to ask, or I'm not clear. And I've just had a look at the question that Honourable Member had asked about Dukamoja. And I can see they have said the workers are currently under self-quarantine at the site, that is Dukamoja in Narok East, until 14 days are over since arrival in the country. Last day of quarantine is 7th March and 13th March. There are two groups, apparently. And then they say none so far has developed any symptoms. So one of the questions that were raised by members, what is this thing that is called self-quarantine? And I have seen they have tried to say something else here, that somebody needs to take responsibility, that self-quarantine is an internationally recognized best practice.
Point of order, Chair.
Just a minute, so that then I was making a ruling.
Point of order.
Point of order, Chair. We are discussing the answers, Chair.
Chair,
proceed. The Chair cannot be out of order. That is one thing. And number two, I'm not discussing it. I've just said what I've looked so that I can make my ruling. So when somebody says this is best practice recommended by WHO, and members here, we have majority of us who are doctors have also said they have questions about this self-quarantine, then we are more worried. And so I want to direct as follows, and this is what we have agreed, that we are going to adjourn until tomorrow because this is an urgent matter. We will communicate the same to our speakers and the clerk of the National Assembly so that they can be able to be communicated to today. And we expect then tomorrow at 3 p.m. that we'll meet in the same venue with the same joint committee so that then we can be able to deliberate. And we're expecting, unless it is an emergency, that we have the people responsible, who are the cabinet secretaries, to come and respond to the matters. And so, members, now I want to put the question that we adjourn this meeting until tomorrow, 3 p.m., and the letters to invite the said cabinet secretaries to be done immediately. So will as many of a similar opinion say aye?
Aye.
And will as many of a contrary opinion say nay?
Nay.
Okay, the ayes have it.
But did you say
3 p.m.?
3:30.
It's okay. When we say 3 p.m., I know members will be at 3 p.m., so the eyes have it already. So members, we have said same venue, 3 p.m.,
3 p.m. we have sitting.
Same venue. We are going to write. That's why, members, it's important to listen. We are going to write, because this is a very important matter. We are going to write to the speakers to allow us, to seek permission to allow us to sit at 3 p.m. tomorrow.
Chair, you have not answered.
We have adjourned the meeting. I request the members of the National Assembly to remain. There is a communication to be done. Professor Nyikal.
I'm calling you. Finishing 5 minutes.
Professor Nyikal, you request the chair. I'm amazed.
Senator.
Members of the National Assembly, kindly, I would like 1 minute. We remain behind.
The upper house in name only.